So here we are with the topic credit appraisal of unsecured loan. So what does credit appraisal mean? This is the lender checking the credibility of the borrower, whether he is able to repay the loan or not. Before we learn about this process, let us know about secured and unsecured loan.
Objective.
The objective behind choosing this topic is that usually not most of the people will choose this topic because it is a challenging one, right? And second reason is that to spread awareness among the students about this topic, because this topic is important in it itself. It is a topic that that will turn handy in long run, maybe in your placement interviews or when you yourself apply for a loan in future.
Next slide.
So we'll go with these are the contents.
The contents are introduction, secured versus unsecured, the process, the revenue size, market growth, and lastly conclusion. Next slide.
Before credit appraisal, what does credit appraisal mean? It is the lender checking the credibility of the borrower, whether the money he has taken is able to give it back or not. So first we'll learn about secured and unsecured loan.
Next slide.
Next.
This is the basic differences between secured and unsecured loan. So what is secured loan? It is a loan given by a financial institution when an asset is used as security against the loan to avail the loan amount corresponding to the asset value.
Moving on to the unsecured one, as the name suggests, this is not secured by any asset value. So there are more risks to the lender, as well as they have more high rate of interest charged on them as compared to the secured ones. Moving on to the process. Next slide, please. We begin with the process with lead generation. This is the process in which the salesperson will go to the customer to get the application form as well as the KYC to be filled by the customer.
The application form includes the residential proof, demographic details, includes the present address, company's name, includes the CTC of the package of the employee, employment details, name, etc. And KYC stands for Know Your Customer, which includes the residential proof, photo proof, and signature proof.
It is to be noted that the work of the salesman is only to collect the details and pass on to the credit team or the credit appraiser for further verification. The next thing what the credit appraiser will do is very crucial, and it is divided into two steps. First step is the obligation, which means he will check the person's previous history, the number of loans he has taken, the number of loans he has paid, and the way of paying loans, if he has done any default method or whatever he has done. Then after that, he will do the civil report, which means giving a credit score based on the person's past history. This score ranges from 0 to 900, and a score above 780 is usually considered as good for approving the loan. After that, he will do a risk segmentation based on the civil report as well as the home loan. He will categorize the person into four segments, like low risk, medium risk, high risk, and very high risk. After that, after dividing, categorizing the person into the risk segmentation, he will directly call the customer and check the application form as well as the KYC with the customer for further verification. Like he will verify the home present address with the rent agreement, his asset verification through the civil report, his employment details through the EPFO. EPFO stands for Employment Provident Fund Organization. After that.
Now, after the appraisal is done, the appraiser will make the CAM. CAM stands for Credit Appraisal Memo, which leads to calculation of FOIR percentage. FOIR stands for Fixed Obligation Income Ratio. So here, it refers to how one deals with the calculation of the loan debts and.
Now, in the calculation of FOIL, the bank will assess whether the person is able, with a certain amount of his salary, the person is able to pay the EMI for the loan or not. After calculation of the FOIR, now it is the work of the credit appraiser to see if the credit, if the loan is to be approved or rejected. If it is rejected, it is sent back to the sales team. If it, if there is need of the verification, he will do the verification, and through the same process, it will go to the credit appraiser. The credit appraiser will now verify and send it to the operations team for the final verification. The work of the operations team is to find, verify it for the final round and to give the money. And at last, we have the closing of the loan, which means deal is done. Next slide, please.
Now we have the revenue size. Here we can see the personal loan, small and medium enterprise loan, and credit cards are categorized as unsecured loans, where personal loan has 3%, SME has 3%, and credit cards has 4% respectively. Whereas home loans and vehicle loans are categorized as secured loans, and they have 2% each.
Next slide, please. Here is the market size. This report is based on the 2018 March report. We can see that unsecured loan consists of about 5 lakh crores rupees of the total 19.23 lakh crores, which consists about 26% as compared to 21% in the last 3 years. Next slide.
Now we have the market growth of the bank, where we can say that the unsecured credit components are personal loans, small and medium enterprises loan, and credit card loans. These three is characterized as unsecured loans, and where compound and annual growth rate is 27%, almost 4 times in the bank credit.
Next slide. Now we see the market growth of the unsecured loans in NBFCs, non-banking financial corporations. These NBFCs have seen a steady growth of unsecured loans in the past years. The share of NBFCs in unsecured loan is gone from 13% in September to 18% in September 2018. Next year, slide. Here we finally conclude our presentation. With the sudden rise of the e-commerce and the startup companies, this unsecured loan has grown 2-3-fold times.
The financial institution will accept both the financial and non-financial aspects in order to determine the borrower's creditworthiness while conducting the process.
It is important to see that every process is done very carefully, and money is given to the right person for the right purpose. For these reasons, there are very many verification, financial as well as non-financial, and keeping in mind the security of the bank's money and to see that the capital and interest of bank are secured. Thank you.
Thank you.